This first video on multiplication of fractions will introduce both the product of a whole number times a fraction and the product of a fraction times a whole number. The illustrations for these two types of products are quite different, but surprisingly are nicely related. To illustrate the multiplication of a whole number times a fraction, we'll use the small step race mat. We'll place a marker at the start. We'll select the 1/2 bar and we'll roll a die. We have a 4. So that 4 tells us that we're going to use the 1/2 bar 4 times. Now since the 1/2 bar is worth 6 steps, we have 4 times 6 equal 24. And since there are 12 steps in each whole bar, we'll go to the end of the first, to the end of the second whole bar for that turn. The number 4 on the die tells how many times we can use 1/2. And we write this using repeated addition. Plus 1/2, plus 1/2, plus 1/2. Add the numerators, 4/2, and that's 2 for our 2 whole bars. Or we could write 4 of the 1/2s. Is 2, or we can write 4 times 1/2, times meaning of, 4 times 1/2 equals 4 over 2, and that improper fraction is 2. Now for the second turn, suppose a 3/4 bar is selected, and we'll roll the die, we get a 5, so again the 5 tells us we're going to use the 3/4 bar 5 times. And 3/4 bar is good for 9 steps, so we've got 5 times 9 equal 45. And this equals 3 whole bars. 3 whole bars in 9 steps. And again, the students might think of having 5 times 3, that's 15. And 15 of these things right here, if you divide by 4, is going to give you 3 whole bars and 3 left over, which is 9 steps. Now the equation for this number of steps is going to be 3/4 plus 3/4 plus 3/4 plus 3/4 plus 3/4. We have 5 of these things right here. Adding the numerators up, we're going to get 15 over 4. There's 4 parts to a whole bar, so we're going to have 3 whole bars and 3/4. Or, using multiplication, we're going to have 5 times 3/4. So we know that we have 5 times 3. We're going to use the 3/4 5 times over 4. And again, we divide 15 by 4. There's 4 parts in a whole bar. We're going to have 3 and 3/4. 3 and 3/4 bars. Now let's move the marker for this 3 and 3/4 bars. So we've got 1, 2, 3 bars and 9 more steps. Now because the game goes fairly fast when you're drawing a bar and rolling a die, we'll go around the racetrack twice. So once we get here, we're going to have 9 more steps. And that's going to take us up to here, 9, 10, 11, 12. So the person has had 2 turns and is starting the second turn around the racetrack. By obtaining a few equations, such as we have done here, and here are examples of 3, students will be able to see that to multiply a whole number times a fraction, we multiply the whole number times the numerator and keep the denominator. 5 times 3, 15, keep the denominator. This is a rule that they can state in their own words, and it will make sense to them. Notice how the small step race map provides motivation for converting the numbers of steps into whole bars. Who wants to count 45 steps when you can go 3 whole bars and 9 steps? I once had a class of college students that said to compute 5 times 3/4, you needed to put a 1 under the 5. Even though the demonstrations with the bars made sense, placing 1 in the denominator was something that had been firmly ingrained in the students from the use of formulas. To illustrate the product of a fraction times a whole number, we begin with 12 chips. Take 2/3 of 12. We think about the meaning of the fraction, 2/3. The denominator here means we're going to divide this set of chips into three equal parts. So we'll put lines down here to divide this into three equal parts. And then the 2 means we'll take 2 of those parts. So 2/3 of 12 is 1. Is that 2 parts right here is 8. And 1/3 of 12, the other 1/3 here, is going to be 4. Students can use chips or other objects to determine the fractional amounts of whole numbers by using the meaning of fraction in grouping chips. For example, 2/5 of 15. We have 15 chips. Denominator 5 tells us we're going to divide the 15 into 5 equal parts. There'll be 3 in each part, and then 2 of those 3s is going to be 6. Using of helps students to remember that the fraction is being used to take part of something. Eventually, of is replaced by the multiplication sign. We have here these products. But even then, it's not a bad idea to occasionally continue to write of over the multiplication sign to help students keep an intuitive feeling for what multiplication means. From such a list of products, students can find patterns. One thing they might notice is that for all of these equations, the product of a fraction times a whole number can be found by multiplying the numerator times the whole number and dividing by the denominator. 2 times 12, 24, divided by 3 is 8. So that will work here. 3 times 20 is 60. 60 divided by 4 is 15. Another pattern students might notice is that the product can be found by dividing the denominator into the whole number and multiplying, in this case, 2 times 4 to get 8. Divide 4 into 20, get 5. 3 times 5 is 15. Notice that dividing the denominator of the fraction into the whole number is exactly the process we used when grouping chips. We had 12 chips. We grouped them into 3 parts with 4 in each part, and 2 of the 4s is 8. This canceling has a nice connection to grouping chips and will help students to make sense out of this shortcut for multiplying a fraction times a whole number. This mat and spinner are part of the fraction base materials. A maca is placed on the octagon, the red octagon with 2 points. The student spins the spinner. Okay, in this case they get a red, so we move to the adjoining octagon, which is red. The 1/2 tells us to take 1/2 of these points, is 4 by 4, so the student will score 8 points. The next student spins the spinner. This time we get white, so we move to the adjacent octagon that's white. And we take 1/4 of those points, is 8 points, so the student score is 2. So this activity provides further practice in finding fractional amounts of sets. Here's a version of the dots game with spinner on fractionbaz.com. In this game, the player can either compute a fraction times a whole number or the product of a whole number times a fraction. For the first spin and set of dots, the player computes 30 times 1/5. The object is to score as many points as possible in 7 turns. The product is small, so the player has chosen to pass in this case. The player can pass up to 3 times during the game.